What we need to do is look at how we make meaning in order to understand how we avoid misunderstanding. The key for him is that we need to look at metaphor because all thought is metaphoric. Meaning is created metaphorically. So metaphor is not merely a cognitive process or a linguistic process, it is a cognitive process. Sadly, he says that at least since the Enlightenment, we've had a very impoverished notion of metaphor. We've treated metaphor as this extra bauble, this sort of shiny thing that we add on to language to make the message go down easier. We have literal language, which actually gets our point across, and we add this nice little shiny thing to it to make it seem more pretty or more interesting or to catch our attention. He says that's absolutely wrong, that all language, no matter how overtly objective it may seem, is metaphorical, and that's because thought itself is metaphorical. So we need a new understanding of the tactics of how metaphor works. We need to look very specifically at how, you know, get under the hood of metaphor, look at what actually happens when we use a metaphor, and by focusing on what seems like a very narrow problem, that actually will help us extrapolate into larger issues of how meaning is made, and therefore how misunderstanding happens. So the next question I want to tackle is, what is the main connection between Richard's work here in the Philosophy of Rhetoric and Jaynes's work? It's probably fairly obvious that the sheer preoccupation with metaphor and sheer an attitude towards it, an attitude that I think is nicely captured in this juxtaposition of quotations. Richard says in 1936, throughout the history of rhetoric, metaphor has been treated as a sort of happy extra trick with words. That metaphor is the omnipresent principle of language can be shown by mere observation. We cannot get through three sentences of ordinary fluid discourse without it. 40 years later, Jaynes will say, the most fascinating property of language is its capacity to make metaphors. But what an understatement, for metaphor is not a mere extra trick of language, as it is so often slighted in the old school books on composition, rhetoric. It is the very constitutive ground of language, and you may not be able to see it quite, but I've actually highlighted cases where even the way they talk about it is, I mean, the phrasing is almost eerily parallel in the way they're describing this. All right, so both these guys think that metaphor is more than this thing that we add to language, it actually is language itself. So with that shared understanding, what does that lead to beyond that? Well, I think we can say a few things that Jaynes and Richards have in common about what happens when we unpack that idea.